So let's say you were to go to a restaurant, and just out of curiosity, you want to see what the makeup of the ages at the restaurant are. So you go around the restaurant, and you write down everyone's age. And so these are the ages of everyone in the restaurant at that moment. And so you're interested in somehow presenting this, somehow visualizing the distribution of the ages. Because you want to just say, well, are there more young people? Are there more teenagers? Are there more middle-aged people? Are there more seniors here? And so when you just look at these numbers, it really doesn't give you a good sense of it. It's just a bunch of numbers. And so how could you do that? Well, one way to think about it is to put these ages into different buckets, and then to think about how many people are there in each of those buckets, or sometimes someone might say how many in each of those bins. So let's do that. So let's do buckets or categories. So I like, sometimes it's called a bin. So the bucket, I like to think of it more of as a bucket. The bucket, and then the number in the bucket. The number in the bucket. Number, I'll just write the number. Whoops. It's the number in the bucket. All right. So let's just make buckets. Let's make them 10-year ranges. So let's say the first one is ages 0 to 9. So how many people, and let me just define all of the buckets here. So the next one is ages 10 to 19. Then 20 to 29, then 30 to 39, and 40 to 49, 50 to 59. Let me make sure you can read that properly. And then you have 60 to 69. And I think that covers everyone. I don't see anyone 70 years old or older here. So then how many people fall into the 0 to 9-year-old bucket? Well, it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 people fall into that bucket. How many people fall into the 10 to 19-year-old bucket? Well, let's see. 1, 2, 3. 3 people. And I think you see where this is going. What about 20 to 29? So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 people. 5 people fall into that bucket. All right, what about 30 to 39? We have 1, and that's it. Only one person in that 30 to 39 bin or bucket or category. All right, what about 40 to 49? We have 1, 2 people. 2 people are in that bucket. And then 50 to 59, so you have 1, 2 people, 2 people, and then finally, ages 60 to 69, let me do it in a different color, 60 to 69, there is one person right over there. So this is one way of thinking about how the ages are distributed, but let's actually make a visualization of this. And the visualization that we're going to create, this is called a histogram. 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 We're taking data that can take on a whole bunch of different values. We're putting them into categories, and we're going to plot how many folks are in each category. How big are each of those categories? And actually, I should have written histogram. So a histogram. So let's do this. All right. So on this axis, let's see, the largest category has 6. So this is the number of folks. And it's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the number. And on this axis, I'm going to make the buckets. The buckets. And let me scroll up a little bit now that I have my data here. I don't have to look at my data set again. So I have one bucket. This is going to be the 0 to 9 bucket right over here. 0 to 9. Then I'm going to have the 3. Actually, let me just plot them. Since I have my pen that color. So in 0 to 9, there are 6 people. 0 to 9, there are 6 people. So I'll just plot it like that. And then we have the 10 to 19. There are 3 people. So 10 to 19, there are 3 people. So I'll do a bar like this. Then 20 to 29, I have 5 people. 20 to 29, which is going to be this one, which is getting, I'm writing too big. So 20 to 29, this is going to be this bar. There's 5 people. 5 people there. So it'll look like this. I should have made the bars wide enough so I could write below them, but I've already, that train has already left. All right, then 30 to 39, I'll try to write smaller. 30 to 39, that's gonna be this bar right over here. We have one person. And then we have 40 to 49, we have 2 people. 40 to 49, 2 people. So it looks like this. 40 to 49, 2 people. Almost there. 50 to 59, we have 2 people. 50 to 59, we also have 2 people. So that's that right over there. That's this category. And then finally, 60 to 69, we have 1 person. 60 to 69, we have 1 person. We have 1 person. And what I have just constructed, I took our data, I put it into buckets that are kind of representative of the categories I care about. 0 to 9 is kind of young kids, 10 to 19, I guess you could call them adolescents or roughly teenagers, although obviously if you're 10, you're not quite a teenager yet. And then all the different age groups. And then when I counted the number in each bucket and I plotted it, now I can visually get a sense of how are the ages distributed in this restaurant. This must be some type of a restaurant that gives away toys or something, because there's a lot of younger people. Maybe it's very family friendly, so every adult that comes in, maybe there's a lot of young adults with kids and or maybe grandparents up here, and they just bring a lot of kids to this restaurant. So it gives you a view of what's going on here. Just a lot of kids here, a lot fewer senior citizens. So once again, this is just a way of visualizing things. We took a lot of data that can take multiple data points. Instead of plotting each data point like we might do in a dot plot, instead of saying how many one-year-olds are there, well, there's only 1 1-year-old. How many 3-year-olds are there? There's only 1 3-year-old. That wouldn't give us much information. We would just have like these single dots if we were doing a dot plot. But as a histogram, we're able to put them into buckets. And we're just like, hey, you know, generally between ages 0 and 9, we have 6 people. And so you see that plotted out just like that. And obviously, this doesn't apply just to ages of people in a restaurant. It applies to all sorts of data that you might want to collect and observe.